What's up, guys? How you guys doing out there? It's your boy Dope Strings here, trying to bring you guys another video for today. Man. It was going good until it went bad. Nah, I'm just messing with y'all guys, man. Trucking. I'm just gonna give y'all a little slight update on what's going on so far right now with trucking and prime. I'm still making good money. I mean, majority of the weeks I make over $3,000, bro. All the weeks I really make over $3,000. Only weeks I don't make $3,000, which I haven't in a long while I haven't been under $3,000 in a while. So majority of weeks I make $3,000, but keep in mind I'm an owner operator. I keep trying to tell people that I'm not leasing a truck from Prime at all, so I don't have those payments. I don't have a $1,000 a week payment. But guys, what I'm about to say. So revenue is good right now for me. Now, what could improve is freaking sitting, bro. I sit a lot, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you guys. The money is cool. Let me just say that. The money is cool. But, bro, I sit a lot. And if I've been running hard and I have a little sitting break or whatnot, I'm cool with that, bro. I'm cool. I don't mind sitting a little bit, man. Here and there, because I ain't gonna say get burnt out, but I do get tired of running after I've been, like, let's just say I run a bunch of nights back to back to back for like one load or something like that. Like, I don't mind running nights, but doing them back to back to back, I mean, I get tired, man. But yeah, I really don't mind that right now because I've been sitting a lot. But yeah. I'm not even sitting because of loads. I'm sitting because the freaking appointment times on these loads. Like, I can't understand. What are y'all doing with the appointment times? I don't understand it, bro. I've been at Prime 6 years, bro. I've never seen appointments like appointments on loads this far out. Like, you can have a load that, let's just say, it picks up on Friday. Well, I think I explained this enough. It picks up on Friday, and the load don't deliver to Wednesday. This is a 3-day load. Like, why can somebody explain to me, bro, at Prime and freaking, I don't know. Somebody in sales, why are the appointments so freaking far out? And I don't mind my ashiness. I don't know what's going on with that too, bro. I've been getting bit up by mosquitoes, man. So I've been scratching the heck out of my ankles, my legs, man. Hey, I don't know what the hell to put on right now at this point. Then I had an issue with my tire, like y'all seen with the community post, bro. Ongoing issue, bro. It's crazy. But anyways, no, like what is up with these freaking Bro, what is up with these freaking appointments, bro? And I'm not the type of driver to freaking just. I'll take these loads, bro. I don't mind them. I'll take these loads with the appointments all the way up. Because 9 times out of 10, I'm going to try to get the appointment pushed up. Either I'm going to drop it at a drop yard, or I'm going to freaking act dumb with the freaking customer to try to get this load off my dang trailer. Out the freaking trailer. Those just my tactics, bro. If those don't work, hey, I'm just gonna be shot out of luck. I should never took the load. But 9 times out of 10, one of those methods is gonna work. If you're near a drop yard, man, you better ask, can you drop that mug off? If you know you're gonna be, if bro, because 9 times out of 10, they'll let you drop it off. If you're gonna be there, if you're gonna be in the area for like freaking 2-3 days, or freaking, well, I'm gonna say 2-3 days, because a day ain't gonna really nothing. But 2-3 days, bro. If you know you're gonna be in there 2-3 days, and you know you can deliver that load, but they're not taking your load until the appointment time, which is two, three days away. Man, you better drop that mug at a drop yard. Ask, can you drop it at a drop yard? Don't just go drop it at a drop yard, but ask, at least. Fill it up, fill that reefer up before you drop it. Because, man, you do not want that freaking reefer to run out. And if it's freaking a produce sensitive, they probably won't let you drop their produce sensitive. I ain't gonna lie to you. A produce sensitive or something that on fuel haul, a product that's on fuel haul, they probably won't let you drop it because it runs 24/7. Unless it's one of those new reefers that we got. Those new reefers, bro, they run a long time. I ain't gonna lie to you guys, they run a long time. But back to what I was saying, bro. What is all these appointment times, bro? They so freaking far out. Bro, in my 6 years at Prime, we had appointments like stretched out, bro. But they have never been this stretched out. Like, I don't know what's going on, bro. I don't know. It's like they want us to sit on loads longer. The loads don't pay that dang good to be sitting on a load for no 3-4 days, bro. And a load that only take a day. I should not be sitting on a load 3 or 4 days that take a day. And I'm not saying that I have been sitting on load 3-4 days that take a day. I'm not saying I have, but because you know what? I just told you what I do. I play dumb with the customer and try to get that thing off my truck the same day. You can't do that with Walmart unless it's a drop and hook. Then they'll probably take you early. But you got to ask your fleet manager and sales and the whole little process. But if it's an OTIF load, you can't deliver that load early, bro. Only an hour before your appointment time. I'm just letting you guys know that. So don't go up there. It could be a $4,000 fine. You don't want that fine. $4,000 fine, bro. It's hard out here enough. You do not want a $4,000 fine. And I don't know how accurate that fine is, which is great. I mean, I don't know how accurate that is. But that's what they say at Prime. So I'm just relaying the message. But anyway, yeah, bro, I don't know what's up with that. But on top of all this, what's going on right now, bro? On top of all that, what's going on right now? Man, I'm scratching like a mug, boy. But, my truck, check engine light on. My truck, check engine light on. Bro, I was trying to get everything done when I took 4th of July. But it's like I'm going to be... I'm going to have to go do something about it. I had a check engine light and I got a little wrench light. All my gauges are good. All my fluids are good. I don't have... Like, the truck is running good, to be honest. So, I know there got to be something small, maybe like an ABS or something. But, I don't have no truck ABS light on nothing on, but it got to be something small, like a shortage or something, because it'll come on and it'll go off. So, what I have been thinking about doing, because I already wanted to invest in the OCR tool. If they want to send it to me. I go review it. But I've been thinking about investing in the OTR tool for my truck. That little subscription, $600 a year. You can do force regens. You can reset. You can reset the after treatment system. You can freaking look at codes. It's like it got live data. All that. It got the whole 9 yards for my truck. So I've been thinking about actually buying that. I ain't gonna say I've been thinking about. I need some write offs anyway for the year. Cause I don't think I ain't even spending as much as I should be spending. But yeah, your boy gonna go goddamn. I'm gonna go do that. I think I'm gonna do it this Friday, to be honest. I might, I don't know. I'm just gonna take it out of my emergency fund at Prime. I'm not gonna take it out of the freaking settlement money that I get. Cause I mean the tool is like they got a special going on. The tool is actually free. Which everybody knows it ain't free, but in the subscription it's like $450, but it's like $600 a year. So what I'm gonna go do, I'm gonna go ahead and spend that $450, man. Tell you that the e-fund. I probably diagnose the truck myself and fix it myself. Cause I know it's not nothing big. The truck is not derating or nothing like that. It's not even pulling up no stop engine light or nothing like that. So I know it ain't nothing serious for real. But yeah. You know, when that wrench light come on, it doesn't give you the full beans, bro. The truck don't give you the full beans, so I got to figure that out. And I don't want to take this truck to Peterbilt. And if I do take the truck to Peterbilt, I'm going to try to finesse them, try to see if they can just hook the dang truck up and just tell me the code or tell me what's going on with that. I don't want them to freaking... But then again, they might try to charge me a diagnostic, bro. In trucking, bro, you gotta have your way with words, bro. You gotta have your way with words. And me being from Atlanta, I got my way with words. If you from Atlanta, you know what we talking about, bro. You know what we talking about. You gotta have your way with words out here on the road, bro. Just like you gotta play dumb with these customers, man. You gotta have your way with words. Just be like, man, I'm about to call Peterbilt, like, en route. I'm be like, hey. I'm be like, hey, Peterbilt. Man, how much is it? Man, can y'all just hook the freaking, could y'all hook the truck up to the arm? Hook the truck up to the computer and tell me what code you getting. That's what I'm gonna be like, can y'all just do that for me, please? I'm gonna go to one of your little country towns. I'm like, hey, I don't need y'all to try to diagnostic truck. I just wanna know what the code is throwing, bro. That's all I wanna know. I don't need to know all that. I figure that part out. I ain't gonna say that, but I'm gonna say, hey, just give me the code. What is it? What's coming up? That's all I need. I don't need you to try to diagnose nothing. Cause y'all charge $200 an hour. I'm just talking, bro. I don't know if they actually charge that right now. But what the world? This dude is driving a really old truck, and that mug is moving. Like, he driving an old, really old truck. I'm like a 70s model tractor. I don't know nothing about no tractors, but I know it's an old tractor. He driving an old tractor, and that mug is moving down the road pretty quick. Like, quick enough that I can't keep up with him. But nah, yeah, that's how you gotta play with, you can't use words, man. Use words like that, so you can go ahead and get that taken care of. So I got a bunch of stuff I do, man. I gotta do the oil change on this truck, man. Make sure they change the fuel filter and all that. I don't even think it's a fuel issue, bro. I was thinking, but I've been reading up, like, bro, could it be like dirty fuel or something like that? But then again, bro, I haven't had no performance issues, so I don't know if it's that. But DPF is saying clean, all that. But I want to run a force regen on my truck, so I'm probably gonna actually try to freaking cut the truck all the way off and freaking try to get it on. And I'm gonna cut it back on after like 30 minutes and see if the check engine light go off. And I try to regen it. Because right now with the check engine light on, you won't regen, which is wild. Cause I feel like I've regen a truck before with the check engine light on. Another Peterbilt that I own. Not own, but one of the other ones I had leased. I feel like I regen one before with the check engine light on. It just wouldn't let you regen with the freaking, with that little wrench light on. But yeah, guys, I gotta get that taken care of real soon. I gotta get that tool. I gotta get that tool bought real soon too, bro. Cause it, man, like, I'm trying to save money out here, bro. As an owner operator, you're trying to save money, bro. I spent $450 on this tool. I ain't gonna say $450 on this, cause they say the tool free. They say it's a subscription, and the subscription is $450, I think, right now. So, and it's normally $600, but I'm gonna go ahead and pay that, write that off on my taxes, and I'm gonna just diagnose this truck myself, bro. I'm actually part of a Packard group. Y'all better go look them up on MX13. They know what they talking about. It's actually a lot of technicians for Peterbilt in that group. So yeah, I'm about to self diagnose the truck myself, and I'm gonna fix it myself, man. Cause it can't be nothing major. As an owner operator, man, you gotta try to save money where you can. And this tool is gonna come in handy, because you can do force regens, you can do all that. So you know when the truck try to derate to like 5 miles per hour, you can clear that, bro. You can clear it and you can get down the road, so you don't have to pay for a tow bill. Cause nobody won't pay that $700 tow bill, man. And I should have bought one sooner. Cause I could have avoided some tow bills, bro. And it works. It don't just work on Packard engines. It work on Cummins. I'm about to say Cummins ISX, same thing. Cummins, it works on freaking Volvo motors, it works on Detroit motors, Packard. I think that's all. It's really like all the new motors it works on. So I'm gonna get this, man. It can help me out later in life. It can help me out later. I gotta actually see, like, I think I looked at it before, because you know I want to have a fleet, and I want to have one of these in every truck, just in case a freaking driver breaks down, and they need to get to the shop. I don't want. Hey, it's. I think it'll be cheaper to get that for every truck, and get that for every truck, so they don't have to freaking get a tow bill to the shop. They can just, hey, regen this mug and take it to the shop. But yeah, I think that'd be their best bet. But if they gonna try to charge me $600 per truck on each, like, a subscription, hopefully it's like you can add a truck for like maybe $15 or something like that per truck or something like that after you pay a $600 subscription. Because I mean, I'm not trying to pay six. If I own multiple trucks, I'm not paying $600 for each truck a year. I mean, it might say more than $600, but still, I don't. But I'm a. I'm not gonna say I'm frugal. Like, I try to save every freaking cent. But bro, I don't like to freaking spend money for real. I won't say I'm like half country boy, half city boy. I got a lot of family that live in the country parts of Georgia. But I was always down there every summer. So, and I was always in Atlanta because I grew up in Atlanta. I mean, I was born in Atlanta. I did all that in Atlanta. So I had best of both worlds, man. So even though I'm from the city, bro, I don't like spending money for real. I like spending money on stuff I actually want to spend money on, like cars and stuff. I don't mind spending money on cars because I love classic cars, bro. I love them. I ain't got to have no freaking flashy rims or nothing like that, but I love classic original cars. I mean, I love shoes. I got a lot of shoes, which I don't take them on the road with me. I keep them in my own storage. I want to actually get back to wearing my shoes, man, but either here nor there. But yeah, guys, what's going on so far, man? We gotta get this truck figured out, bro. We gotta get this truck figured out. And I'm gonna I'll probably record a video when I actually get the tool. But then again, it's like, bro, I was trying to figure out, because y'all know I've been riding without no AC. Should I just get everything taken care of at one time? So I just go ahead and buy the I'm gonna use all the money from in my e-fund. I ain't gonna touch my bank account, but because I have Brock, hey, if you know me, I got like freaking three different savings accounts on my personal side. I got a savings account on my business side. I got a freaking checking account on my business side. I got one on my personal side checking account. And I got another checking account. I got a couple investment accounts. But I got a bunch of stuff going on right now. So I'm trying to figure out where I'm going to take the money from. I'm most likely going to take the money from my e-fund and Prime, because why not? I don't have to touch my accounts if I do that. But I'm trying to debate because I need to fix my APU, bro. I don't like, me personally, with my cam, when me get a new cam and all that, and idling, I don't like to idle my truck. You know, you put more wear and tear on your truck when you idle. So I don't try to idle my truck as much, but your boy, I'm probably gonna get my APU fixed. I'm gonna fix it myself. I'm gonna get the alternator, cause that's all I need is the alternator for that. Then I'm going to, what else am I gonna do? Oh, I'm probably gonna get the tool. But I gotta figure out what it is first, man. That's why I really want to freaking just. Yeah, I'm trying to play my way with words for freaking Peter, but see what they talking about. So I can at least be researching what's going on with the truck and ask some technicians what they think. Because I actually have a technician from Springfield, the mobile guy. I got his car. I got his number too, though, in my phone. I know Clayton is the freaking he the service manager. I'm not talking about him. So that's another guy. Or his name might be Clayton. No, Clayton is the service manager at Springfield, Peterbilt. But we had an issue. I had an issue with him at one time, and he told me just come to him whenever I have the actual service tech. He told me to come to him if I ever have any questions or anything. So I'm gonna hit him up when I figured out what's going on, cause the truck is running good, bro. It's just their check engine light is bothering the heck out of me. And I want to know what the heck it is. So I'm going to get that figured out. But guys, man, I just want to give y'all an update what's going on right now. If you're owner operator, man, hey, man. Hey, no, I'm saying hey, man. No, if you're owner operator, you know a better tool than the OTR tool. If you go to the website, I think it's OTR2.com or something like that. But it's the little green, it got the green and white like logo or stuff right on the page. But if you know a better tool for PACCAR motors, let me know, bro. I'm not trying to do Davi. Bro, I've looked at Davi 4, and Davi 4 is a lot of money, bro. I'm not spending no freaking $1,300, $4,000 on that, bro. I want a fleet, but bro, I don't got a fleet. So I'm not trying to spend that type of money. Nah. That money can go towards the freaking repair, the part, whatever. Cause I don't know how much it's gonna cost me, but yeah, guys, I'm gonna catch you guys on the next video. I just want to give y'all a video for today, cause I know I ain't been uploading as much as I want to upload. Yeah, I actually want to upload some different content from me actually being at home working on my project car and whatnot. But guys, until we get back home, it's gonna be a lot of truck content. Now I really don't want my channel to be a trucking channel, but guys, I'm gonna catch you guys on the next one. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, give me a thumbs up, give me a thumbs down, tell me you like the video. I'm gonna see you guys on the next one. Peace.